They were a humble people, seeking a new life in a new world, free from tyranny and isolation. The Sachs came from Sachland, a small province in Eastern Europe. They sought out America in order to start a new life and to find their match, which could no longer be found in the old world.
I washed a sock, then I hung it to dry. When I came back, it was gone. Mrs. Gertrude Knee-High.
The road to the new world would be difficult. While most immigrants traveled in steerage, the Sockish had to travel in the laundry. It wasn't pretty.
It was hot and sweaty down there. There were towels from Russia, linens from France. No one seemed to speak Sock. It was very lonely, but I was just glad to be on my way to America. Beulah Anklet.
Upon arrival at Ellis Island, the Socks were sorted and tagged. They arrived just with what they could carry on their back or on their head, mostly because they didn't have any hands to carry suitcases. They yearned to become citizens of their new adopted land. The adventurous in spirit headed west. Many were reduced to wiping down counters in local bars. It was a hard life, but a productive one. Over time, the Sockish not only survived, but thrived. Not every Sock lived the straight and narrow path. But today, the contributions of the Sockish are innumerable. From entertainment, to politics, the Sachs have persevered and lived the American dream. And the Sockish American culture lives on.